images right here are one of the first Bronycons that ever happened in 2011, when the community of MLP has started to begin in the first season. And I really say that because today, even if this is an upload date, is the final day where Bronycon is happening. And afterwards, there's not gonna be another one ever again. And I really have to admit that people are gonna be really shocked to actually think that this is gonna be the final time we're going to see Bronycon when it comes to the aftermath of what's going to happen in the next day. Which is why this video is called The Future After Bronycon. Now, considering the fact that I never went to Bronycon, I really don't know what it feels like, but I know that it's a convention. Well, it's celebrating the Bronycon community, but also with MLP material, along with other franchises, but they're basically crossovers that people want to do. And I'm just going to say this right now, that the Bronycon community that started in 2011 and began to grow until this day is probably one of the best experiences that any person has ever had. And it's a coincidence that it's only happening in this decade. Because after 2019, we're going to have to move on and expect what's going to happen for the next of My Little Pony. I'm really saying this because the Bronycon community just feels like a really special place when it comes to people going there when it's summer vacation, while also enjoying of what's going on during the season of My Little Pony. And to be quite honest, if there was a 10th season, then there would be a Bronycon next year. However, since that there's no season next year, there's really no point on throwing a Bronycon. Because even if we do celebrate different material for every Bronycon we go to or any convention, we always discuss of what's going to happen in the seasons of My Little Pony, which is the recent ones. And when you really go to Bronycon, you usually want to meet friends and also discuss of what's going to happen in the next show or next material of what we usually expect from MLP. Now, Bronycon may be a place where we celebrate of what we love about My Little Pony and becoming bronies, but you need to understand this, that without the show, Friendship is Magic, then there would never be a Bronycon. Now, I can understand that Bronycon is mainly about celebrating of what we really enjoy from the show and what we completely enjoy on hanging out with friends. And I have to understand that what we usually expect from the show is what makes us happy in Bronycon. I really think that Bronycon is a really great place for people who become newcomers to the show, and even if they're close or late to the party, they manage to get to a place that they really want, that they never thought they ever wanted to go to, but luckily they managed to, because Bronycon is basically a place of what we usually love, of what the My Little Pony franchise has given us. And just by seeing that this is going to be the final day, it really goes to show that we really need to move on of what's next for the Bronycon fandom. I just think that after so many years where we got so many movies from Aquestria Girls, which actually grow some bronies, and the fact that the show managed to give us so much moments that we will never forget, it has to come to a point where 2 years after the My Little Pony movie came out, we really need to move forward, because we're not going to get a sequel from it. And no, I don't qualify Rainbow World Trip, because even if that is a movie, it still wasn't a theatrical sequel to the movie. And considering that Bronycon is basically one of the places that makes everyone completely happy when it comes to the Golden Age from Hunter Productions, when he said that 2012 and 13 were the Golden Age, I can say that the times when it comes to being part of Bronycon is literally one of the experiences of what we really need to feel when it comes to becoming a fan of My Little Pony. And I'm saying that because it's really the facts. Now, there are other communities who completely do this, but when it comes to the Bronycon community, it was so huge. It was just so hard that it was actually become a thing since 2010 began with the first season. And ever since then, the chameleon has grown bigger and bigger. Sure, there were some issues that we've been seeing over those last couple of years, but at the same time, we have completely make this community a really great place for people who really enjoy the show while also enjoying fans who completely enjoy it as well. Friends who usually expect Bronycon will usually see what we usually expect from the greatness of the show itself. Now, during the years of 2011 through 2014, the show wasn't happening during the summertime. I don't qualify reruns, I'm talking about newer episodes on a daily basis. This was during the Hub era, while in 2015 and now, it was the Discovery Family era. Well, we usually don't know what's going to happen during the middle of this year of what's going to happen with the show. But at the same time, we usually just enjoy the fan arts of what people show when it comes to the Bony community. And I'm saying that because it's true. Because when the Bony community made us completely happy, we usually make some anthologies that we usually enjoy and what we want to celebrate of the Bony community. Because it really goes to show that for what we usually expect from My Little Pony, we can make fan art of it and also fan fiction to show our love towards the fandom. It really goes to show that since 2012, we got a fan fiction website involving My Little Pony material, and I'm actually a part of it. And I really think that when we get to show our creativity to the Bronycon community, really makes Bronycon a really great place. But enough wasting time on what I feel about Bronycon, because right now, let's talk about the future after Bronycon, because, wow, the future of what's going to happen after Bronycon will easily be a really difficult task. Sure, there's going to be other conventions, but none of them will compare to Bronycon. Bronycon, when it's over today, then I don't think that there will ever be a chance of what we're going to expect of what we're going to feel when it comes to friends reacting that the show is coming to an end. And I'm serious. This is probably one of the most interesting ideas of what we're going to expect of what's next for My Little Pony and in Generation 5, since it's going to be the next step of the Bronycon community to handle. And it's not going to come out until 2021, so we have a year, 2020, no material. Well, there might be a question it goes, but we don't know what's going to happen. Of what we really need to expect, or what we really need to handle the situation, that we need to stay in the community while also knowing of what's going to happen with Generation 5, since it's going to be the next step of what we really going to see of My Little Pony. Even though that the Bronycon community was the ones that gave people a chance to meet each other, it's also an understandable reason on why this is going to be the final year. Well, next year, pretty much the next step of the Bronycon community. Like, conventions I can understand, but you need to understand that we really need to see of what we're going to do in the next several years when it comes to the Bronycon community. Because even though that some people may say that the Bronycon community might end because the show is ending, you need to understand that other fandoms completely continued even when the show completely came to an end. Because if that was going to be the case, then all years of being of the Bronycon community will probably be just nothing more than history. And we really don't want that to happen. I mean, sure, we really want to continue our lives to enjoy our love with the Bronycon community, but you need to respect the fact that what we see of the images of all of those years of Bronycon is just literally what we have because of Generation 4. And I'm serious, even though I wasn't a fan of the show before May of 2016, and even though I should have wished I did, I can easily see that there was a lot of changes when it comes to Generation 4 and how it's completely gone since the show was completely changing so many people's opinions on the show. Because after Season 5, there was so much changes to the point that people would easily just stay in the fandom or just moved on. Which I can understand. It's opinions that we need to handle. But keep this in mind, it's literally the show's decisions of what you feel and what you do not feel. And as for me, I try to keep up with it, even with some of the decisions that they make, but concerned of how the show is going with season 9, I think it's literally for the best of what we really need to expect from the Bronycon community. When it comes to Bronycon conventions, just because Bronycon is coming to an end doesn't mean it's going to be the end of time. We still have Generation 5, and I really hope that Generation 5 would easily grow another audience like the Bronycon community. I mean, sure, it doesn't need to be as huge as the Bronycon community, but as long as it's keeping up the Bronycon community, then we might be able to see some kind of a next story of My Little Pony. Because as of now, the older generations minus Generation 4 were pretty poor considering how it's executed in one of the worst ways. But since that other creators who have been working on Generation 4 are working on Generation 5, might take some inspiration and ideas for what we're going to see for the future of My Little Pony. And that's basically what the future after Bronycon is going to be like. People will easily accept what Generation 5 is going to be like, but at the same time, you need to understand that this is literally that today is going to be the final Bronycon. And then afterwards, which is tomorrow, is just basically the next chapter of what we're going to expect from the Bronycon community. And I'm really serious. People really need to understand that even though we did so many activities like music and so much things to worship the fandom, it's just literally what we do for Generation 4. What we need to do for the future is to see what we can see, what we can witness in Generation 5. Even though that this fandom really teaches us so much great things of being together because of Generation 4, the thing is, Generation 4 is all about friendship is magic, while Generation 5 is just a tagline that we need to understand of what it's going to be about. And hopefully it will give people a chance to be together, because it's a way we can easily see the happiness with so many people like us. Now, since that Bronycon is officially coming to an end, let's just make this final day really great. Even though if some of you aren't watching this video when Bronycon is happening as of now, you need to understand that this is literally the final day of what Bronycon is going to be about. And it's just a shame that after today, we're not going to witness it again. But it's basically for the best of what we're going to do in the Bronycon community. And you need to respect the fact that of what people are just going to save the money to go to Bronycon conventions to meet so many fans on the internet while also expressing their love towards the show. I think that Baltimore, Maryland, really is literally the only place where we really enjoy the show, but at the same time, is literally the only birthplace that we expect from Bronycon to be. Yes, Bronycon was in a different place in 2011, but since that Baltimore was a huge place and convention for so many fans to go to hang out with each other, I don't think that there's any convention that Bronycon can do. Yes, other conventions is understandable, but keep this in mind that Bronycon is basically the convention that started so many conventions. And seeing people completely desperate, completely sad that last year when they made an announcement that Bronycon of this year will be the final year, it's just basically what we really need to learn to move on and just let the past die. Well, not really let the past die, but let the past be history and completely make it of what the Bronycon community is what it is now. Even though that I'm never going to be the chance to go to Bronycon, even after today, I can understand of what people are feeling and experiencing during the videos I've watched over those last 3 years. Because when I usually think of people being part of the Bone community, are easily people who really admire the show and what this show has to offer. And it really gave us so many people to be part, to have a group together and actually have a great time together. So many conventions did this, but no other convention like the Bone community would ever have the same ages and great moments like the Bone community did. Anyway, that's basically all I have. I really hope that you found this video interesting despite me stuttering a lot. But keep this in mind, today is going to be the final day, even if it's July 23rd during this recording, but it doesn't matter because I'm focusing on my uploads. You would see that after Bronycon, we really need to see the next book of My Little Pony. And I'm saying that because Friendship is Magic is ending this year. And we really need to see what we're going to expect for the next chapter of Friendship is Magic. Of My Little Pony, actually. Because I'm serious, the moments we've seen from Bronycon is officially over after today. And I really hope that people who completely watch this video might get an understanding that Generation 5 needs to be its own thing. While also just trying to show what we usually expect from the future of My Little Pony. And that's why I'm trying to handle when it comes to Generation 5 material of what we're going to get either next year or in 2021. Because as of now, we really need to expect of what's going to happen next. I'm Lonely Fanboy Freddy here, and I really hope you enjoy Bronycon as it ends tomorrow.